Welcome students, in our fifth video lecture of cloud computing, and our today lecture is encryption techniques. So in general, encryption is the method by which information is converted into secret code that hides the information's true meaning, or it is a way of scrambling data so that only authorized person can understand the information. In technical term, it is a process of converting plain text to cipher text. We can achieve encryption by implementing an algorithm to scramble or encrypt data and then use a key for the receiving person to unscramble or decrypt that information, where unencrypted data is called plain text and encrypted data is referred as ciphertext. The two main kinds of encryption are symmetric encryption and asymmetric encryption. Asymmetric encryption is also known as public key encryption. In symmetric encryption, there is only one key and all communication parties use the same key for encryption and decryption, whereas in asymmetric or public key encryption, there are two keys. One key is used for encryption and a different key used for decryption. Now, the next important question arises that why the data encryption is necessary. It is necessary for regulation, for authentication, for security, and more importantly, it is required for privacy. Some common encryption algorithms are AES, DES, RC4, RC5, RC6, Blowfish, Twofish, and many more. Talking about key in cryptography, it is a string of characters used within an encryption algorithm for altering data so that it appears random. Like a physical key, it locks data so that only someone with the right can unlock or decrypt it. 97% of all organizations use same form of cloud technology. To protect data stored in the cloud, organization must have a strong cloud data policy and be proactive in implementing best practices for protecting cloud data. One of the most important security safeguards for protecting cloud data is encryption. Best practice for cloud encryption involves the following steps. Formulate a cloud encryption policy. Define what data needs encryption and when. Identify where the data reside. Implement encryption solution and key management. So, talking about the first best practice for cloud encryption, that is formulating a cloud encryption policy. It basically depends on industry's organization need to formulate and publish their data encryption policy. The policy should detail specifically what data is subject to encrypt and how it protects the organization and its adherence to regulation. Another important component of the policy is key management. That means who holds the key for deciphering the data and how are the key protected against theft or loss. In this matter, organizations should follow four simple steps in determining how and when to use encryption in cloud. That are, what data need encryption, when data does need encryption, where should cloud encryption be deployed and who should hold the encryption key. Talking about what data needs encryption, so it is clear that not all data need encryption. Non-sensitive data that is already backed up or data for non-crucial operation may not be candidate for encryption. In addition, cost of encryption should be considered. Running encryption in cloud uses cloud computing resources while data is encrypted and decrypted on virtual server. And each instance of this compute power adds to customer cost. Therefore, organization should carefully determine what data really need encryption by considering the following questions. Does the data fall under regulatory compliance requirement such as health record, financial data, privacy, or other legal or contractual obligations? Is the data personally identifiable information? Does the data contain sensitive intellectual property? Is the data essential to the operation of the organization? And other factor may vary by organization. Now, talking about the second step, that when does data need encryption? Most data is not static. Records are updated, new data is added, and files and datasets are often transmitted to and from remote location or between users and the cloud. Encrypting data at rest means data saved on disk or other medium is essential. However, data that moves between cloud or workload or even off-sites, data in motion or in transit is also vulnerable. Therefore, encryption of most sensitive data when in motion should also be considered. If large amount of sensitive data are transmitted, it is definitely a candidate for data in motion encryption. Talking about the third step, that is, where should encryption be deployed? Cloud encryption can be deployed on the storage media or through the operating system, such as Amazon Web Service, Microsoft Azure, and Google Cloud. All provide data at rest encryption. The cloud application, many software as a service application vendor provide operational encryption of data. However, organizations are then logged in to the vendor's encryption technique. In transit over network, although virtual private network and internet protocol security connectivity provide excellent data in motion protection at low or no cost, they may affect network performance. These technologies require certificate management, thereby adding another layer of complexity. And talking about the last step, that is, who should hold the encryption key? So in some cloud service provider, they offer a choice that they manage the encryption key for their cloud customer, or also they allow the customer to manage them. Key management is critical. Loss of key or unsecure key management can put critical data at risk. Therefore, organization should weigh extra cost of cloud service provider manage the key versus the risk of not having direct management of this essential security control. Students, as I have already told you that we are having many algorithm techniques, and one of the popular technique that we are using in cloud computing are like DES, AES, RSA, and homomorphic algorithms, where homomorphic algorithms are more suitable for cloud computing environment. Homomorphic algorithms enable high security than other algorithms such as RSA, DES, and AES. For this, you can study many research papers available in our website, that is analysis of various encryption algorithms in cloud computing. Some of the statistics that I would like to share with you, that is from SkyHigh, recently analyzed that encryption control offered by over 12,000 cloud providers, and there is a good news and bad news where the security of cloud hosted data is concerned. First, the good news is 81.8% of cloud service provider encrypt data in transit as it move between the user and the cloud service using some kind of SSL or TLS. That should help protect data from man-in-middle attack, and it traverses the internet. But the bad news is only 9.4% of cloud provider encrypt data once it's stored at rest in the cloud, leaving it vulnerable to unauthorized access and data breaches. Another key element which is addressing the cloud client connection issue is secure socket layer, where secure socket layer is a protocol developed by Netscape for transmitting private documents by the internet. Secure socket layer uses a cryptographic system that has two keys to encrypt data, a public key known to everyone and a private key or a secret key known only to the recipient of the message. Most of the browser uses secure socket layer, and many websites uses the protocol to obtain confidentiality, user information, in which credit cards number is also there. URL that required an secure socket layer connection starts with HTTPS instead of HTTP. So talking about secure socket layer, secure socket layer provides security to the data that is transferred between web browser and server. Secure socket layer encrypt the link between a web browser and a web server, which ensure that all data passes between them remain private and free from attacks. This protocol hold other four protocols such as record protocol, handshake protocol, chain cipher protocol and alert protocol. This image basically describe the secure socket layer stack protocol, where we having handshake protocol, chain cipher specification protocol, alert protocol and secure socket record protocol. Students, please remember that secure socket layer record provide two services to secure socket layer connection. First one is confidentiality and other one is message integrity. This is the detailed layout structure, how your application data is divided into fragmented and then compressed, which is optional, and then combined with your MAC address and then encrypted. Then this encrypted data is further added with your secure socket layer header, and then it is forwarded. Thanks for watching my video.